Greetings, greetings from the Remnant Bible School Church. Amen. We say shalom, shalom and Torah to all our viewers, all our devotees to God, saints, viewers and subscribers. We bless the Lord. Peace be unto you, we say. There was a blessing, amen, in the last video. 255,000 and I think around 5,000 subscribers, but that's not why we do it. We do it to storm hearts. We bless the Lord. We pray that the Father is storming your heart and that you did not miss that last blessing that went by. A mighty heave, amen, from Hashem for his people. But in case you did, he gave me a word to bring to you. It's called the blessing. We bless the Lord today. I say shalom again. It's important that you listen this one out, okay? Just listen it out. We're coming out of the Torah Sleeve, page 537. There are those of you who wrote it and said, what is the Torah Sleeve that you keep quoting from? Here it is, amen. The Father showed me to show the people where you're coming from, amen. Show them. Torah Sleeve, we bless the Lord. Just took it out of there from the Hebrew, amen. May the rock command his kindness to gather in his congregation. We bless the Lord. From the four winds to be gathered to him. We bless the Lord. And many people out there have got different opinions about what the gathering actually is, what it actually means. But we at the Remnant Bible School Church, we know what it means. We're going to be gathered upon the loftiest of the mountains. And he'll set us down. We bless the Lord. I saw the destruction of one that came under the wings of his cloak and swept and gathered us up and sat us all down in a place grassed and flowered with purple flowers. I didn't know anybody there, but we were all very happy. One sweep in the midst of destruction and all God's people are rescued. He said he shall return unto us to gather in all the outcasts. He shall bring back, is not said anymore, but he shall return and gather in. Amen. Blessed is our God who did us good. Amen. We followed the Lord and he brought the blessing. According to his mercy and abundant kindness, he did great things for us at the Remnant Bible School Church and anybody else that paid attention. May he increase us to magnify his name, Hashem, the one, the Almighty, our Father, our God, our King. May he bless us with a mighty blessing this time around, amen. All spiritual things, amen, are a blessing. Ephesians, Parashah 1 and 3. Blessings in heavenly places. Ephesians, Parashah 1 and 3, I said. Your hope is blessed. Titus 2 and 13. All who have the promises of God are blessed. Hebrews 7 and 6. Saints, the word says that all these blessings shall come upon thee. Hey! Here are the saints and the patience of the saints. The blessings are upon the head of the just and upon the head of the righteous. Proverbs 10 and 6. It depends on which version you're reading from. The blessings are one to be absorbed. Amen. God and his blessing is one to stand in awe of. Not just once or twice, but as many times as you are blessed in your heart, it's a blessing again and again and again. Therefore, with a complete heart, with complete soul, and with complete resources, let us proclaim him King and unique. Amen. You gotta agree with me right there. May he to whom peace belongs set his blessings upon us all, and peace from the left to the right. And may the merciful one, amen, bless his people with peace. Amen. Advisor, mighty God, eternal Father, Prince of Peace, most exalted one, You who rides atop the heavens, go before us with a blessing. Go behind us with a blessing. In the morning and the evening, we pray you will send another blessing. Amen. Bless us with, amen, the double great reward from the one who sees all, we pray. Send the heritage of the peaceful resting place and bless all our subscribers and all our viewers and all your devotees, Father, right now in the name of Yeshua HaMashiach. And may thy Torah guide us in our life, guard us in the grave, and represent us in the hereafter. Hey, our Father, behold our afflictions and bless. Take upon our grievances and redeem and bless. Heal us, O Lord, and we will be healed. Bring complete recovery and comfort to all who are in grief. We've lost many people this year. Just a moment's silence for those out of respect. Bless. Dry the tears of those who cry. Kumbaya. Luabu saints, we love you at the Remnant Bible School Church. Bless, Father, peacemakers. Amen. Matthew 5 and 9. Look to heaven and bless heaven. Mark 6 and 41. Why do I have to look to heaven? Well, people in the past looked to heaven and done blasphemous things. Look at Amalek. Look at Amalek. He took a sword and cut off his circumcision, flung it up to God and spat at it. Said that Ammon done some strange things with himself also towards the heaven. The kingdom of the Father is blessed. Matthew 11 and 10. Woe unto them who send up bad messages. Ladies, do you believe me today? Then blessed art thou among women. Luke 1 and 28, Luke 1 and 42. Blessed is the fruit of thy womb. And verse 45. Blessed is she that believes. Very important for the women to believe also. Amen. Blessed are you that gathers in and disperses, O Lord. And blessed are the gathered. Blessed and blessed and more blessed. Bless us to be gathered in, O Lord. Bless us to see. Bless us to know. Bless us to embrace. Amen. Good. And to hate evil, even the very appearance. Amen. You've blessed us with the Sabbath day, a sign forever. Amen. For all your chosen people. It's so powerful. You took it from us once to teach us a valuable lesson. We didn't know what it was until it was taken away. Amen. Then we missed it. And then you blessed us. From this was the term blessed. Bless and re-bless. Because we had the Shabbat. We lost it, but then we were blessed with it again. That's where the term bless and re-bless comes from, for those who know. Giver of life, taker of the spirit that flies, amen. The Sabbath queen is holy to you, amen. Saints, the word tells us that God has great and good thoughts towards us. But bad mind people and with their bad prayers and their bad deeds and all the blockers of blessings, they have their fate and their part in the lake. When others seek your hurt while you're praying for their success, you're blessed. There's a reward for that and a blessing for you. It is the wise that inherit honor. Saints and devotees, God has a message for you today. I'm going to try and get it out in this video right here. For you, the message has come from the realms of positivity. I have given you good teachings, said the Lord. Do not forsake my Torah. Many are coming in my name saying they got dreams from me. Tell them that they need to say that's what they dream. I didn't tell them that. Like a lot of prophets that are running. And I didn't send them out of vain imagination and and the hope of ripping off the people they're prophesying. Is that right? There are those who are bringing out all kinds of miracles and saying it's all in Jesus' name. But yet still, when this is going on, we don't see not one book open, not a songbook, not a Bible, nothing. Showtime. Do not forsake my Torah, said the Lord. Do not seek greatness, hey, for yourself, robbing me of my glory, eh? Do not crave honor, look, but toil in my word and in the Torah. Do not lust for the table of the kings. Do these and unleash the blessing of the 48 qualities, amen, which are study, attentive listening, articulate speech, initiative and understanding, discernment, awe, reverence, modesty, joy, purity, ministering to sages, closeness with colleagues, sharp discussion with your students, deliberation, knowledge of the scripture, Mishnah, limited business activity, limited sexual activity, limited pleasure, limited sleep, limited conversation, limited laughter, slowness to anger, and a good heart. Oh yes, right here. Oh yeah, it's in there. Faith in your chosen teachers, acceptance of suffering, knowing one's place, being happy with one's lot, making a protective fence around one's personal matters, claim no credit for yourself, amen, being beloved, wow, love the omnipotent, love his creatures, loving righteous ways, loving justice, loving reproof, keeping far from vanity, and not being arrogant. We bless the Lord today, amen, that part. Sharing your neighbor's yoke, judging not your neighbor, but judging them favorably. Amen. Setting people on true courses. Amen, saints, devotees and listeners. Setting people on a peaceful path. Wabu. Some people, they're setting people on a path, but it ain't peaceful. Actually, some people, they had more peace before they were put on the path. Amen. What's that about? It depends, I guess, on how you look and how you carry yourself and what you know and how you deliver it as to how you're treated. 48 qualities, here we go. Learning to practice. Pondering over what you've learned. I said 48 qualities, 24 gifts and 30 prerogatives. But no one's reading these. Look, blessings that come with obedience to the Spirit. Lock out the bad mind people trying to get in. Lock out the known accusers. Lock out the negative talkers. Block out the blessing blockers. Period. Amen. And set these 102 things. Amen. The bad minders, they are missing all of this. There's no blessing there. There's no blessing there. There's no blessing there. If you learn a single chapter, the Torah said, then you have cheered your heart. You have cheered the heart of your teacher. Amen. You are praiseworthy of your achievements. Being wise, you will inherit. Amen. Honor. He's just. The high confers life upon all its practitioners. The blessings. You hear what he said? The highest confers life upon all its practitioners in this world and the world to come, amen. The teaching of the Torah, amen, are like those who find it, saints. It's those who find it. But the life eternal is knowing and believing in the one true God. This is the blessing. There are so many people that just don't believe, and they've made their portion already with all the other unbelievers in the lake. I will redeem your soul, those who are blessed. I will redeem your soul in peace from the battles upon thee. Torah Sleeve, Havdalah, after the Shabbat, page 663. I will change your lament into dancing. I will turn all the curses that are aimed at you into a blessing. Are you believing what you're hearing today? When you are born, your leaf falls, and I catch you when you land. On or into the ground, said the Lord. Wow. I will bless the fallen with support. I will bless the sick with healing, and I will release the confined. Then you will know that I am the Lord. I, God, will bless thee with all these. Are we going to present to our Father anything or anyone or anywhere that can replace these blessings once they are released at the Bible School Church today? They are released by God's saints with our names on them. The seven kings of Persia couldn't stop Daniel's blessing. Not even Sheba couldn't block the Almighty hand. Amen with him in the battle. Who is the him? Solomon. Where he was forsaken at that battle. Not even Sheba with all that she had and all how she looked. She couldn't stop the man from calling on God. I'm telling you, when he thought he was going to lose that war, he quick found God quick. Couldn't stop salvation coming to Zacchaeus' door when Jesus said, it's okay to stop lying now, Zacchaeus. It's okay to stop stealing now. Today I bring a blessing to your house. Amen. Today's salvation has come to thy gates. Our Father, amen, can and does pardon and overlook iniquity. Amen. All in his will. It has to be his will to do it. We have to pray to get it. And when we are free, amen, that we unblock our blessing. He does not maintain his rule forever. Is this not a blessing, viewers and subscribers? To the Remnant Bible School Church globally, talking to all the global remnant, thus said the Lord, I will again be merciful to you and bless you. It's a message, it's a word, it's the truth. Amen, and it's written. From your straits, call upon me, God said, and I will grant you the truth and drown out all your iniquities. Our enemies have forgotten the law, so we forget not the precepts of the Lord. Thy law is the truth. Righteous are thy words and thy blessings, amen. In the morning, in the evening, in our coming, in our going, all around us and beside us and before us and behind us, for 1,000 generations on our children and our children's children, God is for you. I said again, he is for you. Yes. The molder of the universe sends blessings. The heavenly army sends blessings. The angels of God send blessings. The archangels are praying for you and saying, bless them. The occupants of all the world and the cities of God. Amen. The occupants that are of the saved city, the forgiven city, they also say blessings. Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, James, John, Yeshua, Moses, all send their blessings from their afterlife. Amen. When? In the morning, in the evening, in your coming, and in your going. He said, I will bless thee, saith the Lord. I will nullify harsh decrees upon thee. I will nullify designs to hurt thee. I thwart the counsel of all thine enemies. Are you hearing him, saints? He said, I quote, Torah Sleeve, Parashah, from the page 131, I seal the mouths of thine accusers. Amen. Jesus said, where are thy accusers? She said, I don't see none. He said, neither do I condemn you. Rise and sin no more. I am the one who can exterminate the pestilence. I can exterminate the sword. I can exterminate famine. And I can do it all in one day. I, your king, forgive and pardon all your iniquities. I wipe away tears. I remove your willful sins and errors. I am your blessing, said the Lord. I remember you for a good life. I inscribe your names in the book of eternal life. I inscribe your name in the book of redemption. Amen. Here we go, saints. I inscribe your name in the books of salvation, in the books of merits, in the books of forgiveness, in the books of pardon. I make your salvation sprout. I am the blessing. That your voice is heard in prayer is a blessing. That I open the gates, bless the Lord of heaven, to your prayers. Are we calling him a liar today? God forbid. I turn no prayer away empty-handed that is sincere. I am the Lord. I bless the storehouses. I bless and I pity and I find compassion. I atone. I am your rock. I am your salvation. Merciful. I am your blessing. Hashem Yahuwah is making his voice heard today, saints. We need to listen. He is the blessing. This is the word to you today from the Remnant Bible School Church. Amen. One man wrote and he said, Jesus and God are a liar. You're a liar too. We believe though in all the blessings upon which Abba, Father, Abba, amen, has bestowed upon us. Call us a liar if you like. God is not like man that he should lie. Neither Yeshua, the Son of Man, that he should repent. God owes no explanation to you. You need to align yourself, amen. Put yourself in the way of a blessing. Hey! Get your apron out. Hold it out. He's ready. He's riding on the clouds. Blessing. He gave us a word upon which he has caused us to hope. Do you agree? If you agree, click. Amen. Share right now and smash the like button. We bless the Lord. In the scroll, amen, page 1644, verse 237, saints. This is a very spiritual period that we're going through. Many angelic visitors are manifesting themselves to the growing congregation of devotees waiting for the coming of the Messiah. Just as Judah has trusted, amen, and been trusted with the scepter until Shiloh comes, Genesis 49. So we trust in the word of God and his name. Blessings. We trust you for the blessings. When and where and however they fall upon us. Whether it be in the morning or whether it be in the evening. Whether it's in our going. Whether it's in our coming. We receive it that we are blessed. Amen. Our children and our children for 1,000 generations is written and we believe every word. Amen, saints. It's okay to ask the Father for a blessing. Ask and it shall be given, Jesus said. And it can be given today. The calm of the peace. Receive it and be blessed. The heart of your soul may be centered in the Father's will, making his will your will, nullifying the desires of your opponents, your competitors, your enviers, and such kind. For the portholes of his blessings to be opened unto you and to your children and to your children's children. That alone is a blessing, saints. Devotees, saints, and believers, and viewers, and subscribers. Be ye blessed. Receive it right now. Be ye blessed, I say. Be ye calmed. Be ye loved. Be ye comforted. All that moan and all that mourn and all that grieve for your loved ones. Understand that they are free. If they were believers and in the presence of the Almighty, whether in the box or in flight, all are known by the One. Make no idols for yourself and be blessed. Be aware that any idol that you pick bears no hold on the golden palace within the earth. They're lying to you. They're lying to you. All good gifts and blessings are with the Most High God. We bless the Lord. We praise his holy name. Hashem. Abandon foreign deities and be blessed. 331 of the Sukkoth, amen. Torah Sleeve. We bless the Lord. Father says, when we sin, we lose his friendship. He said, when he becomes far away. Now, I don't like the sound of that. I really didn't like the sound of that. What do you mean? He said, yeah, when you sin, you lose my friendship. Our sins separate us from our blessings. Bring massive delays in our blessings. Amen. It's a blessing to be gathering unto the true guidance. Wabu. Hey, where is it at? Ezra, Parashah 4, verse 15. It says, search in the book, amen. Seek ye out of the book of the Lord, Isaiah 34, 16, amen. It's a book of remembrance, Malachi 3 and verse 16. Blessed be the Father, saints. Ephesians, parashah 1 and 3. 1 Peter, parashah 1 and 3. Yes, Lord. Blessed are them that did not see, but yet still they believe. John 20 and 29. You see, these people are talking about, they believe God's a liar. Come ye blessed of my Father. Matthew 25 and 34. Oh yeah. You're blessed that come in the name of the Lord. Matthew 21 verse 9. Matthew 23 verse 39. Mark 11 and 9. Luke 13 and 35. Blessed are your eyes, saints. Matthew 13 and 16, Luke 10 and 23. Blessed are all that hear me today. Hey! Proverbs 8 and 34. Blessed are all those whose transgressions are forgiven. That means it repent. Psalm 32 and verse 1. Here's the order of the true blessings. Amen. For them who are blessed, we bless the Lord. Amen. We name them and they're numbered. Amen. A man said, I have no money. Brother, the blessings of the Lord make thou rich. Proverbs 10 and verse 22. Amen. Get on the blessing road, saints. Smile in the storm, devotees. Calm in the battles. Prayer warriors of God, you shall be blessed. Zechariah 8 verse 13. It's not just doom that Father's got. He said, I will command my blessings upon you. Leviticus 25 and verse 21. Do you receive it today? Amen. He said you'll be a blessing. Genesis 12 and 2. If we are in line for our blessing when it's delivered, then we can be blessed. Amen. If you're not at the supermarket, how can you get the food? Today, if you hear my voice, harden not your hearts. And unto the day of propagation, to the Most High God who loves you, the angels are praying for you. Increase in your faith, knowing that this is true. And let it be your cause to hope and not to falter, love and not hate. Cry peace in the face of temptation, in the face of anger, and in the face of wrath. Amen. Bow before God and stand before men. Peace be with you. Amen. Not as the world give it, give I unto you, said Jesus, and shalom. Blessings come, but there's some more to come. Revelation 14 and verse 13 says, die in the Lord, those are blessed. Revelation 16 and verse 5, watch and keep watch. Blessed and holy is he that has part in the first resurrection. Revelation parashah 20 and verse 6. Amen, we got to make that first wave. Now I'm warning and I'm cautioning. As you get, the closer you get to God is the more harder the devil's going to pull at your skirt tail to pull you back. Why? Because he can see that you're going to go in the first resurrection. He don't want you to go. He wants you to stay here and take a gamble. Oh yes, take a little gamble. See if you make it or not. Get into the what if valley. We bless the Lord. But keep the sayings of your book and you're blessed. Revelation 22 verse 7. Blessed are the pure in heart. Amen. He didn't say bad mind. He said pure in heart. Matthew 5 verse 8. God's plea to man and the women of Israel. If you believe that God is almighty in the blessings, Israel, say amen. If you believe God's got a blessing for you, say amen. Are you ready or are you kind of ready to receive it? You're not ready or you're kind, or you're getting ready. When Jesus comes, there'll be no getting ready. You've got to be ready and packed and ready to go, ready to fly. If you believe the King has found you worthy for a breakthrough or another breakthrough, hey, maybe you've had a breakthrough already. I love you, said the Lord. I love you so much that I sent. I love you so much that I gave. I sacrificed. I tested. I tried. I crucified. I resurrected. And I will redeem. Who believe in the Nazarene. If you said amen, say thank you as well. Toda, toda, toda. I said the Father said that the dreamers can carry on dreaming on their own dreams. I have not visited them. Tell them that I didn't say it in that dream. The fake and the false prophets, P-R-O-F-I-T-S. I never sent them, but they went, said the Lord. Cease and desist, all ye liars, God is watching you. They're magicians, working miracles in my name that I never performed. Cease and desist. But blessed are the true representatives with the truth, that stand on the truth and that stand for the truth. Blessed are all that are corrected by the truth and amend their ways and their doings. We have brothers walking up and down right now correcting people with the truth. Blessed are the remorseful. Blessed are the compassionate. Blessed are the merciful. Amen. And the forgivers of error. Because error is human and to forgive is divine. May God bless and keep you all in the name of Hashem. That sent Yeshua HaMashiach. Some say the Nazarene. Wow. Some know him as Jesus the Christ. No matter what you call him, I tell you. He promised that we will see the Father if we overcome all things and if we believe to the end. He that endureth to the end, the same shall be saved. Solomon said, trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding, lest you lose your blessing, saints. I say, lest you lose sight of your blessing and you're watching others in theirs. Amen. And you're getting all bad mind. What you get bad mind for? You can't get bad-minded to blessed. You got to seek out how they were blessed. Job said, I know my Redeemer liveth. Though he slay me, yet with my eyes will I see him. Like Job, saints, we too should never lose sight of the ultimate blessing. Actually, seeing the blessing, the Ancient of Days, the King of Ages, the Rock of Ages, seeing the Shaddai is the blessing. When we pass from here, and we see the Shaddai face to face, the Lord God Almighty, the one they call Elion, the Most High God, the one they call Adonai, the Master, the one they call Nissi, the Banna, the one they call Ra, my Shepherd, the one they call Rapha, the Lord that heals. You gotta be sick to know him as a healer. The one that we call Shema, Shama, glory. Yehovah Zidkan, Lord our righteousness. Mekadoshkim, Lord who sanctifies him. Olama, our everlasting God. The one we call Jireh, our provider. Shalom, the peace. Sabbath, the Lord that is the host. Always remember that he awaits our audience. And we await his, amen. Imagine finally, he who shielded you, you will see him at last. If you give your heart to God, to worship him and him alone, as Yeshua said, repent and be baptized for the remission of sin and receive the free gift of the Holy Ghost, then the Holy Ghost will bear witness for your soul on the last day. That's one of the main reasons. It's not just to run around and prophet lie and, you know, scam people, whatever they're out there doing, right? That's not the purpose of the Holy Ghost, or to use the Holy Ghost and say, I'm doing this in Jesus' name. It's blasphemy. It's blasphemy, you hear me? Total blasphemy. You have to repent and borrow the prayer of the kings, amen. Amen. King Manasseh wrapped it up. Just check that prayer out right there. Come from that angle and receive your blessing. Receive it today, saints. Because the books will be opened. And our name needs to appear in the right books. Does that make sense? I said for the portholes of his blessings to be opened to our children and our children's children, we gotta walk a straight line. Anybody going past 50 to 60, understand you're in seniority. According to the Torah Sleeve, amen, when you were 17 years old, you should have saved up all the money to marry your first wife and buy your house, amen. Then you had till 21 to achieve that. Then it gives you the age 25, 35, like that, all the way up to 60. Then it goes after that, 70, 80, 90, and then if you live to be 100, well, he can't do much with you then. Time is short. Time is at hand. Don't bother thinking you got a lot of time. No, you ain't. Because you don't know the minute nor the hour when he will put in his appearance. This is the mentality that will cause us to miss out on our blessings. The spirit of arrogance. We can't let it ride up in us. We can't let it stick. We got to realize it could be any day now, any minute now. May our hearts be centered in the Father's will, I say. Making his will our will. That way you nullify the desires of your enemy. I'm going to say it again. When we make his will our will and put our will in his will, then he nullifies all the desires of our enemies. So you don't have to hurt your enemy. All you got to do is line up with God. Amen. And walk in his blessings. And once you are blessed, who can test you after that? Who God bless? No man curse. You never heard that part. Amen. I said the scepter will not part from Judah until Shiloh comes. So we trust in the name of the Lord. And we lean in not on our own understandings. Because we don't want to be our own blessing blocker. Through arrogance, through pride and stupidity. We've got to watch the demon that brings the bad mind. Sometimes we have the heart to do something good. But then we hear a little whisper inside our heart telling us a different thing that is the opposite. Why did that voice even come? Because the enemy that dwells within doesn't want you to get that blessing. The man said, look, it's not working out for me. I've been praying for 10 years. Yes, but are you lined up with the word of God? I understand that you've been praying. Yes, we've all been praying. But have you lined your life up? Are you living the life? You see, saints, devotees, listeners, viewers, and subscribers, I am trying to do my best to get it out to you. This system works. What did I say? To err is human. We bless the Lord, but to obey is divine. I turn no prayer away empty-handed. So what do you mean? You keep coming up with nothing. The Bible said, rise in faith, believing. A double-minded man is unstable in all his ways. Be no more halting on two opinions. These things take the blessing away. This is the word of God to you. I want to bless you. I want to bless you because I know you're true and you're faithful to me. I know you're calling upon my name daily, minutely, and hourly. I got your name inscribed already. I got it inscribed in the book of salvation. I got it inscribed in the book of merit, forgiveness and pardon. Don't let anybody fool you. The jealous ones will say she's lying. Your name ain't nowhere. You know why? Because they want you to doubt. They want to keep you in a place where they feel like you need them when you don't. What you need is the Father in your life. We bless the Lord. Amen. Your King, he will forgive you. He will pardon all your iniquities. He will wipe away all tears from your eyes. He will remove all your willful sins, willful ones, and your willful errors. I am your blessing, said the Lord. I remember you for a good life. And I am the one that inscribed your name in the books. I bless thee, said the Lord. I nullify harsh decrees upon thee. I nullify designs to hurt thee. I thwart the counsel of all thine enemies. Are you hearing this, saints? Are you hearing this? I want to be on the side where I got that kind of protection. I want to be on the side where I got that kind of blessing in the morning. I said in the evening, in my coming, in my going, all around. Before me, behind me, beside me, my left and right side. Not just for me, but for my children and my children's children. How long? 1,000 generations. He sends his blessings from his heavenly armies. He sends his blessings from his angels and all his archangels. Amen. And those that are coming from the city of the saved and forgiven, they send their blessings also. We bless the Lord. I said God doesn't maintain his rule forever. Ain't that a blessing? You don't think that's a blessing? To the remnant globally, I will again be merciful to you. It's a message. It's a word. It's the truth. And it's written. He said, call upon me from your straits. When you find yourself in your straits, that's the time to call upon him. Nothing can stop the blessing. Nothing can stop me from blessing you, the Father's saying. I am the one that blessed the fallen, the sick. In your going out and coming in. In your uprising and your downsetting. I am with you with fresh mercies every morning. The moment you put your foot over the side of the bed, understand this. You're stepping into the blessing of that day. You're stepping into the forgiveness of that day. You wake up forgiven. What you do during the day determines whether you stay forgiven. No one ever told you that before? God doesn't hold grudges, saints. God doesn't keep malice, saints. God is not a predator. He's not going around looking for somebody to hurt. He's not going around looking for somebody to persecute. He's not looking for someone to kill. He's looking for somebody that is in need and or who would desire a blessing. A blessing. A blessing. Well, have you been blessed? Yes, I have been blessed. I have been blessed mightily. And I'm not going to let the enemy try to cloud my vision or turn my blessing into a curse. Whatever the Father has blessed us with, may we eternally be thankful. Much faith, great blessing. Small faith, small blessing. Today, if you've heard my voice, and as the word has said to you today, you're in line, you're in the business for the blessing, you're in the blessing club, you want to get blessed. I think I have told you exactly how, why, where, and when he will bless. Wait patiently upon the Lord and be of good courage, and he will strengthen your heart and bless. Wait upon the Lord, I say, and he will bless. The writer said, they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. He said, they shall mount upon the wings of the eagles. They shall run and not weary, walk and not faint. Teach us, Lord, how to wait. And when the Father blesses you, testify. Do not keep it to yourself. Do not deny it. Do not fool around it. You know he blessed you. Testify. The Father has told me today to come and tell you amen from the Remnant Bible School Church. Behold, I am standing at the door and I'm knocking. If anybody hears me, let me in. Because the gates of blessing are open unto you today. Today, if you hear my voice, harden not your heart as in the day of provocation. Let us pray. Father, in the name that is above all name, we humble beseech and tell you thanks for all that you've done for your people, all that you've done and getting ready to do and getting ready to do again. Because some have been blessed already and you're coming to re-bless. Set our hearts, align our spirits, keeper of our souls, redeemer of our lives. Line us up for a blessing. Those who've been blessed to be re-blessed. We are those who realize you don't just dish out death sentences. All souls are yours. Therefore, we lift up our eyes today unto the hills from whence come our help. You are our help according to Psalms 20. You said you will send help from the sanctuary. Many are standing in line right now, awaiting help. That would be a blessing also. Many are sick and need to rise up from the bed of affliction. Bless them with healing. Many are calling upon your name from confinement. Release them, especially the innocent. Release them to be their blessing. Cover us, O God, with your love. Pardon our iniquities. Pardon our sins. Cleanse us from all unrighteousness and purge us from all iniquity. O God of our salvation, mark us down, O God, in the book of the repented, the book of those who pray. Bless each and every one today with another blessing. Another blessing. The blessing of the heart. The blessing of the Holy Ghost. The blessing of insight to thy word. Take away the cloud from understanding. Take away the darkness from the heart, that we can see clearly and be blinded not according to thy blessing. Redeem us, O Lord, and favor us. Provide our every need according to thy riches in glory, and keep our feet to walk a straight line before you. Mark our footsteps. Be a light unto our path and a lamp unto our feet. Cover all the ministers out there who are ministering the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. There's room in heaven for everyone who wants to go, but it's going to take a certain walk and a certain talk. Give it to us, Father. It will be a blessing. It will be a blessing. We make no longer vain excuses. Neither are we holding on to opinions. We call from the Remnant Bible School Church for you to bless all our viewers, all our subscribers, our all devotees, in the name of Yeshua Mashiach, or Jesus the Nazarene. The church says, amen. Today and tomorrow and the day after that, the angels of mercy will be by your bedside waiting to bless you. For when you open your eyes and see another day, believe me, it's a blessing. It's a chance to get it right. It's a chance to make the change. It's a chance, another day, to drop off things that can't go with us. You can't even take hand luggage to glory. I said you got to travel light. Today, you hear my voice? Harden not your hearts as unto the day of provocation. God bless you all. God keep you all. Amen. And cause his light to ever shine upon you. Be blessed in peace. And may the saving grace of Jesus Christ and the love of God the Father and the full fellowship of the Holy Spirit the Comforter rest, remain, and abide with you all, even now and forevermore. From the Remnant Bible School Church, Shalom.